G'day. This little mathematical puzzle is something of a classic, but it illustrates something very important in mathematics, and let me describe it to you. You're presented with three switches. Now, I wondered whether to use real ones or draw ones. We have a problem in Australia. When we turn a switch on, we push it down. I understand in the United States it's pushed up, and I imagine in different countries of the world you would have one of those options. I think left and right would be a bit risky with people not knowing the difference necessarily. So I'm just going to write on and off if this is the case, but just imagine we have a switch. There we go. That's meant to be a little button or something. These three switches all do a different job, but you're told that one of them is connected with a light that's in a room somewhere, an attic or a basement. The story varies. But only one of them affects this light. And you're told that you're able to fiddle or manipulate with these switches. You can't pull them apart. All you can do is turn them on or off. And then you're allowed to go up and visit the light once, or visit the room and examine the light. And then you must nominate which of these switches controls the light. Now, at this point, I would sit and wait for you. You might ask some questions, but your reasoning would go something like this. If I turn this on and it controls the light, well, the light's obviously going to go on. If I go up and examine it, I think that's the switch. But if it's off, I don't know which of the other two switches it might have been. And I'm only allowed one go. And therein lies the problem. So I'm going to pause briefly. It might be good for you to pause the video and see if you can work out what to do with these switches to work out which one controls the light. Now, let me explain the principle. If we have three choices, three on-off choices, and one thing to examine, then to determine which one affects this, this must have three choices. And this is the problem. Most people just think of the light as being on or off, what we call a state. So here we go, on, off. And as long as you only have two choices but three switches, you'll never solve the problem. But when you realize there's a third state for the light, not on, not just off, but there's off and cold, and there's off and warm. We now have three states. Are you having a little aha experience? So what happens is we can get one switch, turn it on, and wait for a minute or 2 minutes or 3 minutes, long enough for this light bulb, if that's the switch involved, to warm up, to get bright and warm up. Then we turn it off. We turn the second switch on, so I'll put here on off. We turn the second switch on. We leave the third one off, and we go up to visit the room. Now, if the light is shining, we know it's the switch that we just turned on, because these other ones are both off. If I touch the globe and it's cold, I know that it was never turned on in the first place, and that's this switch. But if I touch the globe and it's warm, I know it was the first switch, because I turned it on to warm it up and then turned it off. So I now have three states. So three switches and three states, I can match them up. And this is a mathematical principle. It's used an enormous amount in problem solving and in algebra. Along the lines of this, if you need to know two bits of information, then you need to be given two bits of information. For example, this is for students who are perhaps a little more advanced. If you know how to plot a point on a graph, you know that we need coordinates. Two bits of information, how far to move left and right, and how far to move up and down. In order to locate it, I need to be told about the one and told about the three, or I could be given an equation and given an x value. Now, this, by the way, is not the answer to this. I suppose I should. How's that? That'll be the answer. If I'm given those two bits of information, I can end up with this. I could be given two complete equations. They needn't be straight lines. If I wanted three bits of information, I need three equations. So as many as one needs to be provided with the same number. And that's an enduring principle in mathematics. An example might be too, if you have a function, we're going a little bit more advanced now, and you integrate the function, you get some other result plus a constant, or at least the result includes a constant. And to find the value of the constant, you must be provided with some information. If you integrate this function, so you take a second step, it will produce something plus another constant. And you need to look for another bit of information. So, every bit of information you need, whoever is telling you the problem must provide you with some information to work it out. There we go. Three bits of information required, three bits provided. I hope you enjoyed that.